Previously in Breaking Points.
Right, I'll cut right to the chase, Devin. Tell me what's happening.
I told you, check the comms.
Yeah, the comms are fine, Devin. We checked. What's going on?
Nothing.
Just cut that out. Show me some respect now.
Butler now. Oh, that's not good. Oh, no. Devin Butler spins. He's out.
Done.
It was his hearing. He'd been keeping it from us.
And I was still one of the best while I was out there. You ask anyone.
But if we are going to hit our targets, we need another driver. A permanent one. And fast.
But we are mid-season. It's impossible.
Given the circumstances, do you think you can grant us a bit of leeway on the contract?
I have the projections. If Konnersport doesn't reach fifth place in the Constructors this season, the returns simply aren't worth my time. That was always the deal. And it still is.
But with a little extra time, perhaps we...
Stop! The deal stands. And without Devon driving this... Now, little of interest for me beyond the contract. It's just business.
There must be something we can do.
So, legacy is obviously important to you, Davidov. As a father, I totally get that. So if Devon, your son, can't drive, how about your daughter? Why don't we give the seat to Callie?
No. California will not be signed to Konnersport.
Why not? Just think of the commercial opportunities for the team that signs her, hmm? Forget legacy. You'd be making history.
And you'd be giving a phenomenal talent her first break into F1. It's the right thing to do. Come on, you know she deserves it.
The daughter. You took her mother's name to spite me. Nah, she'll never say yes.
Why don't you leave that to me?
Contract still stands, Ackerman. Fifth place, or I'm out next season.
One problem at a time, eh?
Have you spoken to her yet?
Yes, we've spoken.
And what did you say?
She'll be around this weekend. She agreed to come and see me.
You mean you haven't asked her yet?
Of course not. It's a delicate situation. I'm sure she has an idea, but... look, it's not just something you casually ask over the phone, is it?
Why not?
Come on. This is potentially life-changing for her. And the whole... family situation needs to be handled with a little, care and respect.
Well, you're the one that knows her. Just make sure she says yes and fast. I'm finding it difficult to keep fielding questions about the future of Konnersport.
Yeah, I read part of that interview. Could almost feel you squirm.
That bad, huh?
Worse. Look, I'll call you as soon as I know.
I don't think we're in for a quiet one today. It's race day here at the Circuit de Barcelona, Catalunya. It's an updated track at Catalunya, and the popular opinion in the paddock is that we never wanted the chicane in the first place. That's now been gone, the final corner is much faster, and at 2.9 miles and 14 turns, we await the Spanish Grand Prix. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole. Sergio Perez lines up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have... Verstappen, Russell, Norris, Hamilton, Gasly, Sainz, Oscar Piastri, Fernando Alonso, Tsunoda, Joe, Sargent, Bottas, Jackson, Magnussen, Ocon, Hulkenberg, De Vries, Stroll, Albon, and Noah Bell. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. Welcome to the wonderful Catalunya. It's time for the Spanish Grand Prix this weekend. And whilst the season is just a few races old, it's already been one full of drama. So, Natalie Pinkham, who have you got your eye on this weekend?
Well, in Formula One, naturally, the conversation is drawn towards those at the top of the standings, both drivers and teams. But I'm really intrigued by the midfield team of Konnersport. Devin Butler's absence will definitely be felt. There's no doubt about that, both on and off the track. For me, the interesting thing will be how they move forward without him.
Indeed, almost as many battles off the track as there are on it for Konnersport at the moment. And Kasper Ackermann and his team certainly have their work cut out for them this weekend.
I know it's been a mad few weeks, mate, but you've always gone well here. So let's get your head down and see what we can do. Come on.
Available.
really good stuff. That's P10. It puts us into a great point scoring position. Okay, you're in the top 10. The gap to the car in front is 2.0 seconds. That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Well done. Nice move. Keep going. Approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums. job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. Gap to your teammate behind is 28.3 seconds. Push hard on the inlap. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Job, nice overtake. Noah's coming in for his stop now. work. That's a new fastest lap of the race. Laps of fuel remaining. Okay, clear. Right, we've got enough fuel for three more laps. We'll be right back. mate. Final lap. Keep your concentration and let's bring it home. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining. Okay, the gap behind is 32.3 seconds.
Jackson propping up Konnersport here today, but the big news off the track is the speculation about this team and whether or not they'll see out the season with their current lineup.
Well, I think they'll have to sign a new driver, Crofty. It's a gamble worth taking.
Well, a mid-season signing would get us all talking, I'm sure, but time will tell. Well, I'm thoroughly exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way onto the podium now.
Well, Konnersport are in a bit of an odd situation right now. So, just tell me, what is it like for you today?
Yeah, not so long ago, my teammate was Devin, and we had a plan sorted out for the rest of the season. Now it's Noah, and for the last couple of races, suddenly nobody's quite sure what the situation is. I've never had to drive in this situation before, so it's all pretty strange, but you do what you can.
Most importantly, how is Devon? And how are you finding it without your teammate?
Yeah, I know as much as everybody else. So, you know, I saw what happened. I'm obviously very worried for him, and as is everybody else. And, you know, I know he's not fit to drive for us right now. As far as I know, he's working super hard to return to the sport. And, yeah, I wish him well.
Well, there's a lot of talk about what happens if Devon doesn't return. Would Konnersport be looking for a new driver, do you think?
It's not for me to say, but I think it could be a real opportunity for the team to make an exciting signing. There's a lot of talent out there hungry for a shot in F1, and Konnersport could find themselves in a perfect position to offer them one.
Well, thank you for chatting with us. Great to have your time.
Speak to me?
Yes, I did.
Shoot.
Nothing major, really. To be honest, I just wanted to thank you.
Oh. What for? I'm, you know, just doing my job.
No, it's more than that. Well, I know why you stayed on the team. And, well, I won't lie to you, it's not been easy.
Yeah, you can say that again.
Yeah, but you really stepped up. It's good for me to know that I've got someone like you to rely on.
Always.
Yeah. Look, Aiden, I'll warn you, things may not get any easier, at least not for a while, but Well, we've got something in the pipeline. A potential new driver, and a damn good one.
Who is it?
I can't say. Not yet. It's a bit of a gamble. But if they agree, we could have something special.
Nice. And, how is Devin?
Fine. I think... I'm not sure. I mean, Davidov has closed the door on that one, but... Yeah, he tells me Devin is in a good place, though.
Oh, that's good, that's good.
Just keep doing what you're doing, okay? And now, just get out of here.
Of course. I'll catch you later, Casper.
I'll do everything in my power. Everything. To make sure that all you have to think about is driving. Have we got a deal? You might never get this opportunity again. You know that. PlayStation.